There seems to be a really aggressive and sincere desire to gut a lot of the IRA bill from the administration.
A lot of the manufacturing announcements as a result of the IRA came in those red states. And so Republicans are in a little bit of a pickle because they're seeing all the benefits of manufacturing coming in.
So I think the worst of all the scenarios is the uncertainty that we're living in now.
Absolutely.
Welcome to In the Loop with Larry. This is our March 2025 edition. And boy, we're going to discuss the IRA bill, the opposition to gutting the IRA bill, and just where things stand right now in this really complex and time of uncertainty. So welcome, Larry.
Thanks, Warren.
So Larry, last week or a couple of weeks ago, 21 House Republicans signed a letter advocating to keep the IRA portion of, at least to keep the clean energy tax credits that are a part of the IRA bill.
Yeah, that's right. So we saw a couple of articles come out. One that we looked at is from Renewable Energy World, where they are just letting the industry know that there's these 21 House Republicans that signed a letter basically saying that they believe that these renewable energy tax credits from the IRA bill are valuable and they want to keep them.
Yeah. And I mean, it is a tight squeeze. The Republicans can only afford to lose a couple House Republicans on this. And there seems to be a really aggressive and sincere desire to gut a lot of the IRA bill from the administration. So this is going to be very interesting to watch how they navigate and work through this. And to add to that, it appears from this article from Renewable Energy World that the majority of the beneficiaries from those tax credits have been in red states.
Yeah, so I think, Warren, that's the key to this whole situation. So there were no Republicans that voted for the IRA bill. It was completely partisan.
Yeah.
Completely by the Democratic Party, and Biden, of course, approved that. And so right from the start, Republicans have in the back of their mind, as soon as they get back into power, they're going to gut this whole thing. But what happened was a lot of the manufacturing announcements, and this article mentions Michigan, South Carolina, Georgia, North Carolina, Texas. A lot of the manufacturing announcements as a result of the IRA came in those red states. And so Republicans are in a little bit of a pickle because they're seeing all the benefits of manufacturing coming in. The other thing that happened is a lot of the installations of solar projects are also in some of those states. Texas, Florida, Right. Obviously California and New York, sure. But Texas and Florida, Georgia, maybe a couple other states in the Southeast, some states in the Northeast like Ohio, Pennsylvania, where we're at, a lot of states that are kind of on the line that are getting a lot of benefits from the IRA tax credits.
Right. But we can expect this uncertainty to continue. It looks like they're shooting for Memorial Day to get a reconciliation bill passed, which is 2.5 months away.
Yeah.
If they hit that target. So hopefully there'll be some clarity as they work through this. But I don't think they're getting a sense of any clarity in the next few weeks.
Yeah, I would agree with that, Warren. I mean, we're getting bits and pieces of what people are hearing.
Yeah.
And the bits and pieces are all over the place. It's all over the place from, hey, this is the last year for the tax credit, all the way to, you know, this is the last year for the tax credit. The adders are going to go away, all that. Domestic content's going to be required in 30%, all the way to, hey, we think that the adders are going to stay and this stuff is going to be around for several years yet. So it's really all over the place. And probably what's going to happen is a couple of these Republicans are going to negotiate some extensions for some of the tax credits in, you know, to get their vote on the overall bill. That's potential what's going to happen.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see it, but most certainly it's hard to predict what's going to happen. I would not be surprised if it gets completely gutted, and I would not be surprised if there are very little or no changes.
Yep. Now, probably the changes that will happen will be changes to the grant programs.
Yeah.
The REAP grant program from the IRA bill, that funding will most likely be diminished significantly or maybe go away for future years. Some of the larger Solar for All, some of those grant programs, I would imagine we're going to see some of that stuff go away. And the one thing that's a little bit alarming, Warren, is the way that Trump's been able to get Republicans in the House and the Senate so far to really fall in line with what he wants.
Right.
And so we'll have to see, you know, when it comes down to it, will these 21 Republicans really vote against it? Will they negotiate really hard? Or is this just lip service to say, hey, we wanted to keep it and we couldn't? I don't know. It'll be very interesting to see what happens.
It will. And it'll be nice to have this behind us. I think the worst of all the scenarios is the uncertainty that we're living in now.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Now, the good news, Warren, is that we have seen, and a lot of our customers have seen, and a lot of states have seen, the benefits of the IRA tax credits and how it has helped U.S. manufacturing, how it's helped get projects in the ground quickly, how it's helped add energy production in the U.S. when energy production is really challenging to add quickly. It's a way to do that for the oncoming need for energy that we have in the coming years. So we've seen that, and hopefully they'll take that into consideration.
Yeah, I can't imagine, and I could be wrong and could be surprised, and I wouldn't be surprised if I were surprised, but the amount of investment that foreign companies, even domestic companies that weren't manufacturing here, have made since the IRA bill was signed to begin manufacturing here, opening up plants and buying buildings and employing employees. If the IRA, the domestic content piece of it, went away, the impact that that would have on companies moving to America to produce their products.
Yep, it would be significant. There's been significant benefit to the U.S. economy, and it would be significant if it was taken away. So I guess we'll see.
Yeah, stay tuned. It's going to be part of the solar coaster for sure.
Absolutely. And hopefully we'll know more in probably not the coming weeks, to your point, Warren, but probably in the coming months.
Yeah, I think it'll start to, in the next couple of months, we'll start to get a little bit of clarity, see what it's going to look like. And we'll get to watch the show.
Should be good.
Yeah. All right, Larry. Well, thank you for your time.